What does a field engineer do? In this video, I'm going to explain the crucial duties of a field engineer and the perspective and mindset they have to have, their purpose, their main responsibilities, and how to succeed. So I love this. This is my jam. Every construction project, every company, everywhere in the world should have field engineers. We have project engineers everywhere for the office side, but we've got to have field engineers enabling the craft in the field. And so I'm going to tell you what this crucial role does in construction. By the way, if I ever tanked my business and had to go back and do work in construction, I would never, ever, ever, ever do anything or work on any job or work in a company where they didn't have field engineers. It's just not a thing. And so for those of you who don't have it, don't be mad. We have time, we can get the training, we can get the program, we can get the title, and we can get the culture that will sustain for you the systematic training of future superintendents and the shaping of the builder mindset in all of your people. Like, it's absolutely fantastic. So let's do this. So number one, the field engineer focuses on where. The owner and the design team and the superintendent and the project manager, they'll focus on, in the PE, they'll focus on what, why, how, right, when. But the field engineer focuses on where. Where does that embed go? Where does that line go? Where does that top of wall go? Where does the reinforcing go? Where does the wall go in and of itself? Where do the grid lines go? Where does the building go with inside the site? Where does the primary control go within the state plane coordinates? Like where? Field engineers focus on the where. Project engineers focus on what with procurement, and what trade partner, and what are we gonna pay you, right? But the field engineer focuses on where. It's a crucial role. You can spend hundreds of thousands of dollars on location problems and mistakes and QC problems if you don't have this crucial role. So let me talk about the role. Primarily have field engineers to train future superintendents. And here's what we ask them to do. We ask them as their number one skill to figure things out, which is huge. When you see superintendents nowadays, as a whole, don't get mad at me. They don't know how to use computers, most of them. They don't know how to even sometimes to read plans. They don't know certain technologies. They're not advancing with lean methodologies. They just do the same thing, firefighting over and over and over. They're not learning and figuring things out. And so that skill of figuring things out, learning and adapting and being nimble and growing was something that you learn as a field engineer. When you put into a superintendent position, you're primarily incentivized, if you don't know the skills, you're incentivized to kind of fake it and to really just point and tell people to go different places. It's hard to learn as a super if you didn't learn as a field engineer. Field engineers are here to make the next generation of supers, and their first priority is to figure things out. The second priority is to enable the craft. If you put a field engineer next to the craft workers and you jam out or have them jam out with each other, they're doing layout together, they're doing port checks together, they're doing placements together, they're learning from each other, they will form such a connection that that superintendent will never disrespect a craft worker the rest of his or her career. The third thing a field engineer is there to learn to do is to be the honey badger. If you've ever seen those videos, honey badgers, they'll go get honey and be stung by bees. They'll attack a cobra and get bit by the cobra and literally fall down and get back up again. They don't care about any danger. They are brave. They move forward, they get what they want, they grind, they get it done. So we want field engineers to figure things out for the purpose of supporting their craft with the ability to get anything done as the honey badger. That is the system. So let me talk about how we should approach this. As a field engineer, you must learn construction. We will link you in the description below to a different video that talks about how to learn construction, but you are here to learn it as fast as you can. You as a field engineer are also in charge of executing frontline safety. Your superintendent PM will create the safety plan according to the local rules, but that safety plan, you are boots on the ground, eyeballs in the field. You have the authority as project management to get it done, not as a jerk, but as somebody who holds the line and does not tolerate mediocrity in the field. You hold the line when it comes to frontline safety. After that, you are the first line of defense when it comes to quality. You are a part of those pre-construction meetings. You help create those quality checklists. You check the work according to those checklists. You help schedule these first in place mockups or the initial inspections. You are constantly doing port checks. You are constantly doing double checks overhead in wall. You are the quality hands of the superintendent, boots on the ground in the field. You are the first line of defense for quality. The other thing, and I know this isn't very popular, but I'm telling you, you need it. Field engineers do layout and control. They establish primary or at least double check it if a professional surveyor did it. They always bring in secondary from primary control. They bring in working control for things like columns and walls in the building from that secondary control. They lay out embeds, they shoot elevations, they help with placement checks, they check elevations through the building, they control the exterior plumb. They do layout and control with coordinate geometry, and they are highly skilled at it, and that sets a mindset of visualizing things in 3D as they become supers in the future. Field engineers also create lift drawings, meaning you might have an architectural set of drawings, electrical set of drawings, lab equipment. You've got the vendor specific equipment, and there's four or five different locations on the drawings that show where one outlet's supposed to go. It is your job to combine all that information into what's called a lift drawing, because you're lifting it from other places and providing one last final coordination drawing. Field engineers do lift drawings for site structures, for all concrete, for masonry. They do lift drawings for key installations throughout the building, critical interfaces. Again, they do it to solve problems for in-wall coordination of the rooms and complex things like head walls inside the building. Field engineers do lift drawings. They know how to study the drawings. They know how to read the drawings. They know how to interpret the drawings. They know how to write RFIs and review submittals. The key is lift drawings, number one, teach that field engineer about the building. Number two, find problems before they become a problem. And number three, are used to install work in the field. Field engineers do lift drawings. Another thing with those lift drawings, with that layout, and with this mindset that the field engineer has, he or she will problem solve. I typically, when I see superintendents overwhelmed, I'm like, hey, hold on. You plan and execute work. The field engineer and project engineer can answer the RFIs and the submittal questions. These trades don't need to be coming to you with technical stuff all day. Route that to the field engineer. They are professional problem solvers. Field engineers also prepare reports and charts. They perform office duties like the creation of RFIs and the reviewing of submittals. Sometimes they even help with subcontractor payoffs. They are there to support the superintendent. And in some cases, they can even support a crew for their self-perform work. The bottom line is, the role of a field engineer is crucial, and we have got to start making them. It would be like us saying, I want to raise a herd of cattle, but I don't want any babies. I just want cattle. Well, where are the cattle going to come from? I don't care. It's your problem. I don't want any babies out there. You've got to have little baby cows if you want to have big cows, right? If you want to have a herd, you want to grow the herd, you've got to tolerate the calves. You've got to tolerate the newborns. If you want to have superintendents, you've got to have field engineers. You can't say, I'm going to run a company with superintendents and I just want superintendents. Don't have field engineers. I just want superintendents. If you never have a place to grow superintendents, every company, every job must have supers, and they must have field engineers growing that next generation and supporting the supers on site. That is the way builder construction happens. In the link below in the description, I'm going to give you a link to a podcast series on this that I hope you will enjoy. I'm telling you, this will change everything for you. I hope you've enjoyed this video. On we go.